What's up, everyone? It's TechTrooper64, and today is time for my E3 2017 predictions for Bethesda Game Studios. Now, I'm a huge fan of Bethesda. As you can see from the gameplay, I'm playing The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim Special Edition on PlayStation 4 Pro in 1080p. I've been always a huge fan of Bethesda and Elder Scrolls. I was never a huge Fallout fan, but Elder Scrolls was really one that I liked a lot. Wolfenstein wasn't bad either, but, you know, if I'm being perfectly honest, like I said, Elder Scrolls was my bigger, more popular one. But I also actually did like The Evil Within, but that wasn't really made by Bethesda Game Studios. That was more published by Bethesda. But anyway, so what are my predictions for Bethesda? Well, just like before, there's going to be 5 predictions. These ones are ones I think are going to be shown at E3. These are all my own personal opinion, what I think is going to be shown. And there's going to be a bold one at the end. The fifth and final one is going to be a very bold one, which means there's a very high chance that it's not going to happen. But if it does, that's great. And that's something I really want to happen. So without further ado, let's start. So the first prediction I have is actually related to The Evil Within, the horror game that was released in 2013. I believe that The Evil Within will get a sequel, or The Evil Within 2, and it will come out, and it will be shown with a trailer, a CGI trailer, and a gameplay trailer on stage. The game will also have a collector's edition, and you'll also be able to get it for PS4, Xbox One, and PC with a release date in the holiday of 2017, possibly in October to coincide with Halloween, but that's just what I think. What they might do as well, and I was just thinking about this, that they might re-release The Evil Within in like the first Evil Within in this complete edition that comes with all the DLC, because I don't think they've done that yet. So I think if they do that, it'll be really, really cool. Personally myself, I would be very excited for it. I also think it might come out next year, so early 2018, but I'm really hoping it'll come out this year. The second one is a brand new Wolfenstein game. This was actually because in one of the trailers, I think, for Fallout, the DLC for Fallout, the trailer that was shown at E3 last year, inside like one of the screens or whatever, it showed like this really pixelated screen, and the screen showed that there was a Wolfenstein something. I want to say what name it was. It was like Wolfenstein Behemoth or something like that. It was this weird name. And I think that was kind of like teasing that there is a Wolfenstein game coming, and it'll be the first time the Wolfenstein game will be developed for PS4 and Xbox One hardware exclusively. Which is a first for that series. And I think the new Wolfenstein game will either come out in fall of 2017 or holiday 2017 for PS4, Xbox One, and PC. The third one is kind of vague, but we don't really have details about it. But we do know that Bethesda has been working on brand new IP for a while. They've been working on 2 games specifically. And I think that they're going to announce both of them, like the names, what they're about. What can you expect from these games? The first one, I think, is going to be a open world game. Oh, sorry, I mixed it up. I think the first one's going to be a RPG. I don't know exactly what kind, but I think it'll be an RPG. It'll come out this year. While the other one is going to be have a bigger world than Fallout and Skyrim put together. And it's going to be a huge game. They're going to advertise that it's going to be an amazing big game that you should be excited about. I don't know if it's going to be an established brand already that, like, already exists, but I think it's just going to be, like, this open-world game, and it'll be released in 2018, specifically in the summertime. I think they're just here to show us what they are working on, and they're just going to say, like, hey, we have no time to release it this year, but we are going to release it next year, and it's going to look great. Anyway, moving on. The fourth prediction I have is kind of to coincide as kind of a continuation of what they showed last E3. Last E3, they announced that Fallout 4 VR is coming to HTC Vive. I forgot exactly what happened, but I remember reading that either, I don't remember if it's coming to Oculus Rift or PS4 as well. I don't remember. I'm pretty sure it's just staying to HTC Vive, but from what it sounds like, it might be coming to both. I don't know. All I know is that, or at least what I think, they're going to show more details about it this E3. Like, during the press conference, they're going to say, hey, yeah, this is what Fallout VR is. They're going to show, like, a trailer of it and the gameplay, and they're going to show someone playing it on stage and how it looks and how it plays. And this is kind of a bold one to go with it, but they'll also announce Skyrim VR. I know that's kind of, you know, out there, but I think what's going to happen is they're going to tell us, like, Skyrim's very popular, Fallout 4 is very popular, and we saw that people bought Skyrim in droves, so, you know, hey, let's make it Skyrim in VR as well. That's just me, but I feel like, if one game's getting the treatment, the other game should too. Like, Fallout 4 and Skyrim has kind of gotten the same treatment this year. I don't know if you guys noticed, but, like, when Skyrim got mods, Fallout got mods. When Skyrim got a fix on PS4 Pro, Fallout got a fix on PS4 Pro. So I think those two games couple together very well. So I think if Fallout's getting VR, it's most likely that Skyrim's going to get VR. Anyway, moving on. This is the bold prediction, the one that is probably not going to happen, but I really want to happen, and I think it's going to happen. The Elder Scrolls IV Oblivion, the game before Skyrim, is going to get a remaster, or in other words, a special edition. It'll have improved graphics, textures, visuals. It'll look a lot better and nicer, and it will be out this year by October 2017, just like Skyrim was last year. And Bethesda will end their conference by teasing The Elder Scrolls 6 with very little detail. Like, they won't even show gameplay or a beta gameplay. They will literally just show you a logo or tell you, like, the setting or, like, some concept art on a screen. And then they'll say, this is Elder Scrolls 6, or they'll show a CGI trailer. And then they'll say, it's coming in 2019. Like, that's my guess. I think that's what's going to happen. I could be wrong totally, but I think that's what they're going to end their show with. Because, you know what? People have been asking questions about Elder Scrolls 6 for a while, and I know that Todd Howard already confirmed that Elder Scrolls 6 is not happening only because... Or, it is working. They're working on it just in very early stages. Like, they don't even have a game engine working yet. And the reason why is because they've been working on the two new IPs I mentioned previously. And they're working on those more right now. So I get that. But I think that they will at least reassure us with some sort of trailer, some sort of logo, or some sort of concept art to tell us Elder Scrolls 6 is coming. Please wait one more year. Then we'll show it next E3. That's just me. But those are my top five predictions for the Elder Scrolls developer Bethesda Game Studios and what I think they'll show at E3 2017 this year. I want to hear what your guys' thoughts are on my predictions. Let me know in the comments down below, and be sure to rate, comment, favorite, and subscribe to my channel for more updates and news when E3 2016 comes in the next 4 or 5 weeks. I'll see you guys next time, and enjoy E3.